Hi, you guys, it's Billy B. Today we're doing Becoming Lenora Claire. Lenora Claire is an LA institution. She is the queen of nightlife. Los Angeles Magazine has voted her like who's who in LA. She's an art curator, she's a radio host, she's a television personality that happens to be my best friend. So stay tuned for Becoming Lenora Claire. I hope you enjoy it. All right, so I am starting with this. It's L'Oreal's fabulous new product, Magic Nude, and it is a liquid to powder foundation. It's kind of like it does so much of the work for you, it makes you feel a little bit lazy. So I'm using my own foundation brush from my line of brushes. It goes on with incredible coverage. So you just blend it in. This happens to match your skin perfectly. And Lenora has stained lids.
He called them my rusty lid.
Yeah, it's her rusty lid. Mm-hmm. But I'm gonna show you, I'm doing half her face. Now this is what is so fabulous about it. You're done, there's nothing else to do. You don't have to powder it, you don't have to do anything. And now look at that. It's pretty magic. Well, they do call it Magic Nude, it's magical. So now I'm just gonna do this other side. I'm doing really sexy makeup on Lenora because she's hosting the anniversary party for the Pleasure Chest. You may pretend you don't know what the Pleasure Chest is, but all of you do. Everyone secretly sneaks in with a bag over their head and buys stuff.
Right.
Anyway, I'm going to start in the crease. This is from the infallible line of L'Oreal eyeshadows, Bottomless Java. And my brush from my brush line, number 12, which is a soft angled brush, perfect for creases. So it goes right in the crease. And I don't blend it out too much because the blending process will sort of come throughout. But this is where I just sort of start creating the shape for this sexy eye. Now I'm gonna take an eyeshadow brush. I'm gonna sort of use this to blend into that brown and hollow out this sort of area. And I just like to use powder. Didn't really have to be shadow. And then as I said, I just sort of blend throughout. So I'm gonna take some onto her brow bone, sort of blend that out. A lot of the time I'll do one side of the face first, just to sort of work out what I'm doing. And then it's amazing how much faster it is doing the other side because you sort of figure out so many shortcuts that you can take. I'm gonna put a little bit of this shadow behind her lashes, but I'll end up going in with eyeliner later. When you're sort of cutting in the crease and you really are contouring the eye, that's what you're doing. I'm gonna now jump to contouring her cheeks and lips and all of that. It's kind of like mixing the batter for the cake, and then in the last 5 minutes when you're doing the icing is when it all comes together. I take a foundation brush and create sort of a hard cut, like right under her cheekbone. So I'm using the brush this way. This is from my line too, my foundation brush. Sort of really cut in there, like this, and then smile, Lenora. And then right under the apple, just sort of hook it under where her apple is, and then turn it the other way to sort of blend that out. This is Lenora's favorite part.
That's where your brush turns into a magic wand and gives me exactly what I wish I had.
No, they're there. I just help them a little bit.
Yeah.
These are very neutral colors. It can be an eyeshadow, it can be a blush, because this is, again, just sort of the contouring part. Then if you want to go even deeper, you come in, this is like a brown, right? So just a thin line right there, smile. And then, like I said, hook it under the cheekbone. And then with what's left on the brush, I'm going to turn the brush this way and just buff that out and up into and under her cheekbone. You're helping what is naturally there. If someone's on a red carpet, if lots of people are gonna be right in their face looking at them, you want to take that into consideration of how they look. So you always want it to look fairly believable to the naked eye. This is from my line, the number 3, and my brushes are significantly smaller than most. They're very, very short, so they fit perfectly in your hand. I love them. But anyway, this is what I use for a blush brush and a powder brush. So usually blush brushes are gigantic. See how small this is? But it's perfect. And I'm using L'Oreal Invisible Lift blush that I love. And the trick about this is it's got sheen in it. The light plays on the sheen and it creates like a lifting effect. You can see the sheen. That is what is going to sort of give this lift to her cheek. So I always have people just smile and then just sort of buff it right onto the apple of their cheek. You want to make sure you want to blend it into that darker contour.
Mm. They call it sheen because when you wear it, you're winning.
Oh, that's funny. I'm going to jump now to curling her eyelashes. Look down. This is my eyelash curler. And what I do is get it all the way to the base of the lash and then pulse it like this. And it gets an incredible curl. And the same thing over here. Gently pulse. And pinching a client is not a lot of fun. So I try and be really careful. And then there you go. I am using L'Oreal mascara. I love the Shocking Extensions mascara. I love this wand because you can get right into the base of the lash. Gently lift the person's lid up and it pulls it out away from their eye. And it lessens the possibility of getting it in their eye or irritating them. See, I get all the way into the base. Lenora is a lash girl, so we're going to end up putting several sets of false eyelashes. But my pet peeve is when someone doesn't do lashes, their own lashes, the natural lashes first. It really helps to integrate them more naturally into the false lashes. I take a brush. I created this brush specifically for this, among other things, but it's my brush number 9. It's a small little brush that's flat on the end. You can get right into the base of the lash and really coat the lashes and make no mistake. That's why I did it. You know, using a wand is really difficult because once you get mascara on the lash and it's wet, if you move it, it ends up getting underneath the eye. And it's so smart that now I'm telling everybody about it and developed a brush for it. It's perfect, flawless bottom lashes, really maximizing the potential of the lash, and I didn't make one mistake. It looks like fake lashes. It's so great. For somebody that you really want to get a good curl, after the mascara, after it's dry, and I'm going to do it one more time, right at the base again. Just make sure that the mascara is dry. See how great that is? So what I'm doing now is I'm lining her waterline with white. It's an old drag trick, you know, stage and for operas and things like that. But what it does is it really brightens and whitens and makes the eyes look bigger. It's better to do it before the mascara because it's easy to get on the mascara. Close. I'm going to take, this is really black, again from the Infallible line with L'Oreal. This time I'm not going to blend it so much. I'm going to put some right in her lash line and then I'm going to connect that with what I just did in the crease. So there you go. So that is where I'm really coming in now. Close. And I'm not going to blend this out very much. By the way, this is the same brush that I did the mascara with. So right in the lash line. And then I'm going to sort of fill in the outer corner, but it really creates a sort of cat eye. I'm going to take my eyeshadow brush, which is a number 8. I love this brush. This brush I covet. I couldn't do makeup without it. To add to that line I just did, there's going to be a bit of a blending that happens. Blending is, I think, the key to beautiful makeup, no matter what kind of makeup you're doing. My number 5 brush. You can use it for aqua color, paints, wet things, for spot concealing, for lips or whatever. But I love it also because it's soft. Look up. To go right in her lash line, right into the base, and just smoke that out a little bit. And I love this infallible shadow. This one is eternal black. It's got a sparkle that's perfect in my quest to help Lenora Claire snag a man. Look up.
Or three. That three coming.
I love this brush too. This is number 13. This is good for everything. But it's so good to do this, and I'm just softening that line underneath. Don't be scared of the shadow. You can just go right over it. Just dig in. You can't be afraid of it. All right, so now we're gonna come in with a coat of my favorite, always fabulous, L'Oreal Voluminous Mascara in Black is Black. So now we've got the lashes curled and mascara'd. Put the glue right at the base of the lash on the lid the way you would apply liquid liner. You don't put any on the lash, and so you don't make a mess when you're sort of placing it. Isn't that a smart thing to do? So there you go. And then just tap it in. I use several pair, and then I add one, and then I trim them and sort of create my own big lash, I guess. Never heard of them. Amor Us. And it's number WSP, and for all I know, it came from the 99-cent store. So I'm gonna take a little bit off of this, like a half an inch. Now place that right on top of the other and tap it down. Now I just sort of go crazy. This is from the same iconic L'Oreal Voluminous line, and it's their new Butterfly Mascara. It really gives you that iconic winged out effect. But let me show you what's so great. So you kind of have to unlearn what you've learned. This contour that you see here, this is what really gives you that winged out effect. This, the way it's contoured, it grabs and encapsulates all the way to the outer extension right in there, like that. This is L'Oreal Telescopic Precise Liquid Eyeliner, and it's got this felt tip. This helps hide where the false lashes are attached. I do short little strokes like this. And then a good trick is to bring it down and literally sort of paint the base of the false lashes, just so that you hide any glue or anything like that. While it's still damp, just use your finger to bring that out for the extension, and then you can just do it to taste. Let's see. Of course, it's perfect. So the lips, we always do, what else?
Red.
Red, I mean gorgeous red. So this is L'Oreal Crayon Petite Lip Liner. It's really important to line the lips because it helps, because when you do a lot of color, like a rich, bright color, it has to be perfect. This is just the same makeup that we do if she's going to a bar mitzvah, if she's, you know, just a synagogue, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or to the pleasure chest. It's all the same to us. Look, it's perfect. All right, OMG, okay, if you don't have fun tonight with the three guys that you already have lined up and the 300 that you'll end up meeting. Now see, you guys have to admit that in the last 3 minutes is when it kind of all comes together. So when you're doing makeup and it's not coming together, don't beat yourself up, give yourself time, give the makeup time to sort of find itself. Trust me, it always will. All right, you guys, so there you have it, Becoming Lenora Claire, the finished product, with the help of Lorena Soria, who did the hair, who did wonders, did amazing, 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 so thank you very much.
Thank you.
We'll be hearing more from her. So anyway, you see nice Jewish girl who looks like a big dirty which is perfect for tonight's event. Bye.
Bye. Bye.